Good morning and welcome to our Holden team service for this, the second Sunday of Epiphany. I'm here today in St. James and I'll be joined in leading this service by Jim Quin and Tricia Stuckey, both of them from their own homes. Times remain really tough for so many at present, and I know how much many of you miss the fellowship of meeting together in church, and how much we miss you not being here. We still have some difficult weeks ahead, but there are also signs of hope. I've spoken to several people this last week who've now had their first vaccination. People can't speak highly enough of the organisation at Dawlish Hospital. I've had direct contact with two of our residential homes, where in the last week the residents have had their vaccinations. There are indeed signs of hope. And so we have our first hymn, O Worship the Lord in the Beauty of Holiness. We meet in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you, and also with you. So we pray together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The grace of God has dawned upon the world through our Saviour Jesus Christ, who sacrificed himself for us to purify a people as his own. So let us confess our sins. God be gracious to us and bless us, and make your face shine upon us. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May your ways be known on the earth, your saving power among the nations. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. You, Lord, have made known your salvation and reveal your justice in the sight of the nations. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Eternal God, our beginning and our end, bring us with the whole creation to your glory, hidden through past ages and made known in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now Tricia's going to bring our first reading.
The first reading is Psalm 139, verses 1 to 5 and 12 to 18. O Lord, you have searched me and you know me. You know when I sit and when I rise. You perceive my thoughts from afar. You discern my going out and my lying down. You are familiar with all my ways. Before a word is on my tongue, you know it completely, O Lord. You hem me in behind and before. You have laid your hand upon me. Even the darkness will not be dark to you. The night will shine like the day, for darkness is as light to you. For you created my inmost being. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful. I know that full well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in the secret place. When I was woven together in the depths of the earth, your eyes saw my unformed body. All the days ordained for me were written in your book before one of them came to be. How precious to me are your thoughts, O God. How vast is the sum of them. Were I to count them, they would outnumber the grains of sand. When I awake, I am still with you. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The next day, Jesus was wanting to go back to Galilee. He found Philip, said to him, "Follow me." Now Philip was from Bethsaida, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, "We have found him about whom Moses and the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus, son of Joseph from Nazareth." Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." When Jesus saw Nathanael coming towards him, he said of him, He is truly an Israelite in whom there is no deceit. Nathanael asked him, "Where do you come to know me from?" And Jesus answered, "Before Philip called you, I saw you under the fig tree." Nathanael replied, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God, you are the King of Israel." And Jesus answered, "Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under the fig tree? You'll see greater things than these." He said to him, "Very truly I tell you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." This is the Gospel of the Lord. Now, John's Gospel is different from the other three, we know that. We're not always as aware that each of the Gospels is composed with different audiences in mind and with somewhat different emphases. They were expected to be read out like today, as the Old Testament scrolls were read out in the synagogue. It's only in the last few hundred years that we've been able to have our own copy of the scriptures. Perhaps lockdown is the ideal opportunity to make the most of that gift. It means we can read much longer passages than in our services and so see better what the overall message of the writer is. Anyway, to our present passage. It opens with the next day. So, obviously, it's part of something much bigger. For John, that story starts before anything is created. In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And then we hear John the Baptist crying in the wilderness beyond the Jordan, "Make ready for the coming one, the greater one." He sees God's Spirit coming down on Jesus and so recognizes that he is the promised one who baptizes with the Holy Spirit. He points Jesus out to his own disciples, and two of them follow Jesus and are invited to spend the afternoon with him. They become convinced that he is the promised Messiah. Andrew is one of these, and he shares the news with his brother Simon. Andrew brings him to Jesus, and Jesus gives him the new name Peter, the rock. And now follows our story, the next day. Jesus wants to go home to Galilee. He finds Philip, a Galilean like Peter and Andrew, and calls him to follow. Philip finds Nathanael, another Galilean, and the rest you just heard. Now, the two things stand out for me in this sequence. First of all, the number of different ways that Jesus is referred to. You can look them up yourself. It just indicates, starts from the Word made flesh, and it ends up with Nathanael's Son of God, King of Israel, and Jesus's angels of God commuting between heaven and earth, using the Son of Man as their ladder, as in Jacob's vision 1,000 years before. The second thing to strike me is the variety of ways that people are said to come to Jesus. For John the Baptist, he is the promised one, the one recognized as such when he is baptized. Andrew and his companion are intrigued when John the Baptist points Jesus out as Lamb of God, like the Lamb sacrificed to save the Hebrews in Egypt, and they follow him and are invited by him to spend time together. As a result, Andrew recognizes Jesus as the promised Messiah. He finds his brother and brings him to Jesus. Simon becomes Peter. So, three Galileans are drawn by John the Baptist way down south, and they are now attached to Jesus, who comes from the north. Jesus himself finds another one, Philip, Philip brings Nathanael. Now we have a core of five Galileans rescued from unfaithful Israel to start work at home up north. Jesus recognizes Nathanael as a true representative of faithful Israel. He promises him even greater revelations of heavenly things in and through the Son of Man. And that's what the rest of John's Gospel is about, beginning with the wedding in Cana, Nathanael's hometown. So, John, in this, his Gospel introduction, does two things. He challenges us to explore the multitude of ways that we might want to think and talk about Jesus. And secondly, he wants us to recognize and marvel at the infinite variety of ways in which we as individuals come to and stay with Jesus of Nazareth, Son of God, Son of Man, Messiah, and how we might help others to do the same. The whole gospel awaits our attention for ourselves, for others, and for the world. Amen.
In this time of uncertainty, let us pray for ourselves, for our community, our nation, and the world. And after this prayer, we'll have a time of quiet with a piece of Taze music as we offer our own prayers to God. Keep us, good Lord, under the shadow of your mercy. Sustain and support the anxious. Be with those who care for the sick. And lift up all who are brought low, that we may find comfort, knowing that nothing can separate us from your love. In Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. O Lord, hear our prayer. Our Saviour Christ is the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace there shall be no end. The peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you. Gracious God, accept the offering of your church, the hearts of your people joined in praise and thanksgiving. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give him thanks and praise. All honour and praise be yours always and everywhere, mighty Creator, ever-living God, through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord. For at this time we celebrate your glory, made present in our midst in the coming of the Magi. The King of all the world was revealed to the nations. In the waters of baptism, Jesus was revealed as the Christ, the Saviour sent to redeem us. In the water made wine, the new creation was revealed at the wedding feast. Poverty was turned to riches, sorrow into joy. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we lift our voices to proclaim the glory of your name and sing our joyful hymn of praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. How wonderful the work of your hands, O Lord. As a mother tenderly gathers her children, you embraced a people as your own. When they turned away and rebelled, your love remained steadfast. From them you raised up Jesus our Saviour, born of Mary, to be the living bread, in whom all our hungers are satisfied. He offered his life for sinners, and with a love stronger than death, he opened wide his arms on the cross. On the night before he died, he came to supper with his friends, and taking bread, he gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." At the end of supper, taking the cup of wine, he gave you thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Father, we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. We remember his dying and rising in glory, and we rejoice that he intercedes for us at your right hand. Pour out your Holy Spirit as we bring before you these gifts of your creation. May they be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy things in your presence, form us in the likeness of Christ and build us into a living temple to your glory. Remember, Lord, your church in every land. Reveal her unity, guard her faith, and preserve her in peace. Bring us at the last with all the saints to the vision of that eternal splendour for which you have created us, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours for ever and ever. Amen. Rejoicing in the presence of God here among us, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Let us pray. God of glory, you nourish us with your word, who is the bread of life. Fill us with your Holy Spirit, that through us the light of your glory may shine in the world. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace and opened the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We whom the Spirit lights give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Christ, the Son of God, perfect in you the image of his glory, and gladden your hearts with the good news of his kingdom. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, rest upon you and those for whom you pray, this day and always. Amen. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, amen. And so we have our final hymn, All My Hope on God is Founded.